Good morning. This is a Morning Sun news break, and I'm Brian Stout reporting. French jets bombed Iranian guerrilla bases deep behind Syrian lines in eastern Lebanon yesterday. The bombing was retaliation for the bombing of the French barracks in Lebanon last month. At least 30 people were reported killed or wounded in the jet assault. Meanwhile, Palestinian guerrillas continued fighting with Yasser Arafat's Lebanese forces near Tripoli. Palestinians mortared and fired rockets at Arafat's jets yesterday, while Arafat, with his hand bloody and bandaged, vowed to fight to the end. Lebanese police sources say nearly 1,000 people have been killed in the 2 weeks of fighting. Senate and House negotiators approved a $249 billion military spending bill yesterday. The bill includes $24 million for Nicaraguan rebels, but no money for nerve gas production. The Senate and House are expected to give the bill final approval today before recessing until January. The American Cancer Society has announced that a record 19.5 million smokers joined in the 7th annual Great American Smokeout yesterday. That figure is 35.6% of the nation's estimated 55 million smokers. The Cancer Society's telephone survey of 2,123 homes showed 29% of men smokers and 43.7% of women smokers were attempting to complete the 24-hour nicotine fast. Governor Blanchard has signed a law authorizing the Agriculture Department to condemn and dispose of PCB-contaminated silos. When the funds have been appropriated for the cleanup, attention will focus initially on some 90 to 100 silos that had recently been in use. Under the bill, the contaminated silos will be removed and disposed of by the Agriculture Department, with farmers being reimbursed the structure's market values. PCBs were originally used in silo coatings to protect concrete blocks from silage acid. Isabella County's United Way campaign has reached 94.4% of its goal. Executive Director Susan Walling says that as of yesterday, $186,896 had been contributed to the fund drive. Walling says contributions from several major firms have not been received yet, so it looks like the United Way will achieve its goal of $198,000. The county's United Way campaign ends November 30th. Looking at sports, the CMU football team closes out their season tomorrow when they travel to Toledo to take on the Rockets. If Central beats Toledo and Northern Illinois loses to Ohio University, the Chippewas will share the MAC championship with the Rockets and win a trip to the California Bowl. Other games in the MAC, Miami of Ohio hosts Cincinnati. Kent State is on the road to Bowling Green. As I mentioned earlier, Northern Illinois entertains Ohio University, and Eastern Michigan is looking for their first conference win when they travel to Western Michigan. In high school football action, the Beale City Aggies will be playing for a trip to the Silver Dome when they take on the St. Ignace Saints tomorrow in Petoskey. The winner of that game advances to the Class D championship game to be held in the Silver Dome on November 26. In the NBA, rookie guard John Sunvolt scored a career high 24 points, 10 of them in the final period, to lead Seattle. Past Chicago 119 to 110. In other games, Washington downed Indiana 102 to 94. Atlanta beat Philadelphia 99 to 94. Dallas edged New Jersey 115 to 113. Kansas City snuck past San Antonio 129 to 128. Denver topped Golden State 131 to 120. It was Los Angeles 127, Cleveland 114. And San Diego beat Milwaukee 141 to 122. In ice action last night, Bobby Smith's goal midway through the third period turned out to be the game winner as the Montreal Canadiens defeated the Montreal Red Wings 4-2. John Andrnik scored both of the Wings' goals. In other NHL action, Boston beat Toronto 4-1. It was Quebec 4 to Hartford 2. Calgary edged New Jersey 5-4. And Minnesota and Philadelphia skated to a 5-5 tie. Taking a look at the weather forecast, Today, there will be increasing cloudiness with a high in the mid-40s. Tonight, it will be partly cloudy with a low in the low 30s. Tomorrow will be mostly cloudy with a chance of showers. The high will be in the upper 40s. In the extended forecast, there will be a chance of rain Sunday, cloudy Monday, and a chance of rain developing again late Tuesday. Highs during the time will be in the low to mid 40s, and the lows will be in the mid 20s to low 30s. This has been a Morning Sun News Break. I'm Brian Stout reporting. Now, to more sunrise.